Hello there. Welcome to part 5 of this tutorial. Today, I'm going to be going over how to spawn enemies, as well as how to randomize spawn positions and times. Hope you enjoy. Before we begin this tutorial, I'd like to mention that Godot 4 is out now. Which is great news. However, it makes things a bit complicated. The main issue is that transferring projects is not easy and takes a bit of time. Because of this, I'll be sticking to Godot 3 until this tutorial is over. Thankfully, you should still be able to follow this tutorial even if you are using Godot 4. Thanks for listening, hopefully we can make some cool projects with Godot 4 in the future. Now let's get started with this tutorial. Spawning enemies in Godot is relatively simple. We can start by adding a timer, I'll name it our spawn timer. This will control when our enemy can spawn. Now we can add a main script. What we'll be doing here is instancing our enemy when the timer goes off. I'll start by creating a preload variable that will preload the enemy. Remember to add the enemy scene. Now we can add the timer to the main script. Go into the timer and add the timeout signal. I'll create a variable that instances the enemy. Now what I want to do is decide where the enemy will spawn from. Let's go into the scene. I don't want them to spawn in the same position each time. To get a better estimate we can use the grid. I'll want them to spawn anywhere between 100 and 550 units. What we'll need to do now is set the enemy position equal to vector 2. In here, we'll need to set up two random range methods that will account for both the x and y axis. This will randomize the position between two points. On the x axis, I'll want an enemy to only spawn at 1024 units. On the y, I'll want them to spawn anywhere between 100 and 550 units. Now we can add the enemy. Now that that's done, we can go to the timer. I'm going to select auto start so that the enemy will spawn automatically. Great. The enemies are spawning in random ranges, but they are still predictable and spawn a bit too fast. We can change this by randomizing our timer. This will allow for a lot of variety and more of a challenge. Let's begin by adding a script to the timer. This will be where we'll randomize the timer. The first thing we're going to do is create a minimum and maximum variable. This will allow an enemy to spawn anywhere between these two times. I'll set the maximum value for 5 seconds. You can change the maximum time depending on how quick you want an enemy to spawn. Now we can make a ready function. First I'm going to make a method called spawnTime. We'll use this later. Now we can connect our timer's timeout signal to the spawnTime function. In the spawnTime function, we'll set our wait time to be between a random range, which will be our maximum and minimum times. There, that's better. Now the enemies can spawn in random positions each time we play the game. Thanks for watching. I hope that you found this useful. See you in the next video.